Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making fat-free cream-style gravy to go with our turkey, which is right here, just finished, just got carved. And it came out of this pan because I had used this pan to brown it off. And the juices are all in the bottom here. And to make this fat-free, I'm going to need a strainer like this, which also separates the grease from the actual turkey juice. So I'm going to just pour this in. Just pour it over the edge there. And watch as it fills. You don't want to do this overfull. And I'll have to take a second step on this, which I'll do in a minute. But I want you to see that there is about that much grease in the spout, and there is grease from here up. A lot of people just start making their gravy with that in it. I don't believe in doing that. So the grease goes out the spout, and then I can go over to my saucepan where I'm going to make my gravy. And all of this is just turkey broth. It's not fatty, but I stopped short of getting that layer of flat fat that was at the top. It always goes to the top, and so you can count on it being there. So here we have our fat-free turkey broth, and I said I was going to make this cream style, so that means that it's going to be skim milk for me. I always keep skim milk in my refrigerator and nothing else, unless there is a very special need. And I usually make my gravy with water and cornstarch, but this time we're going to use milk and we're going to use flour as the thickener. So I'm going to put the flour in the milk and stir that together before I put that into the broth. And you know, I think I could use a smaller spoon than this, so I'll just move over here and grab a spoon. Stir this up a little bit. If you don't stir it up, then you're asking for lumps. And you may be able to stir them out, but maybe not. I'm sure when we put this in, there will be a few lumps. But we will stir this continuously as it's being heated right at the beginning. Then we can just stir occasionally. So get your milk, 1 cup of milk, and your flour. 2 tablespoons of flour mixed together, and then you may pour them in to your broth. So now, this spoon, which has a little flour on it, I think I'll just scrape that off. I'm going to take this spoon, which is a better spoon for stirring at the stove. And you'll see there are a few lumps, but those will cook up. What I have over here at the stove is some water. I've got 2 cups here. That's for thinning it down as it needs it. We'll just start this and we'll see how it goes. I'm going to turn it on and I'll keep you up to date, or when I come back I'll tell you what I have done if I've had to add water. But I do want to stir this as it heats, and as it heats those lumps will be stirred away and we'll have some nice creamy gravy, but it will be fat free. Here is my cream style gravy that goes with the turkey, and you can see it's very thin. That's thinner than I would like for it to be, and I did not use any of the water to thin it down because obviously I didn't need to. So I want to show you how to thicken up gravy. I had started out with 2 tablespoons of flour and 1 cup of milk, and added it to the amount of fat-free broth that I had from the 8-pound turkey. And I was just estimating that might be about right. But you always have to go with an estimate and then go from there. Like I said, I might have to thin it down. Actually, I have to thicken it up, which is harder, but I'm going to show you how to do it. Take what I have here, a couple of teaspoonfuls of flour. I think that's probably what it would need. And then pour some water in there, just enough to blend those together. It doesn't really matter. You don't want to pour a whole lot because you're not trying to get it thinner. Mix this around. Now don't just pour this directly into your gravy. You'll just make a big biscuit or a big dumpling in there. It will clot, it will lump, it will not be good at all. So what you're going to do is take a good amount of your gravy, which is boiling hot, put it in here and immediately stir this around. And let's take a little bit more. Get this up to temperature. You want to get this up to temperature. It's just like if you're adding eggs to something and you don't want the eggs to cook, then you have to get those eggs up to temperature before you add them in. But that looks nice. It's not a problem. So we're going to slowly add and stir. Just add and stir till you get that all in. And you'll notice that this will thicken up. And now I will be in a position where if I need the water to thin it down, then we can go in that direction. But I definitely thought it was too thin to serve, so we had to do something about it. And I thought, well, that's something good to show you all in case you have that problem, because no two turkeys are going to give the same amount of fat-free broth. So the amount I had just was too much for what I put in with it. So this is looking pretty good, but you have to cook that long enough for the flour to be done. You actually have to cook flour, or it won't taste right. It'll taste raw. So just give this a minute or so. I'll come back when it's done and I'll pour it up. Our cream style turkey gravy is done. So I'm gonna pour that from my saucepan into a good sized bowl. It was bigger than just a gravy boat's worth. So you'll see it's nice and smooth. And I don't have a ladle that is appropriate for gravy handy right now, so I'll just put a spoon in there and show you what it looks like beside the turkey that it will be served with. But it's just about the right consistency, and you might have noticed that I did not add salt. The reason I did not add salt is that when you roast a turkey like I did and you butter and salt the inside and the outside, all of that cooks and the drippings will be salty. They will be salted. So you will not have to add salt to your gravy. It will taste great like it is. I hope you enjoy both the turkey and the gravy.